Hey guys!
Welcome to the review show. Us again, as ever. Sorry that we couldn't be with you last week. We did turn up here with a show ready to air. And
they had more important presenters, I think, last week.
Yeah, there was about 20 10-year-olds in this studio. We couldn't kick them out either. They were on a special school trip of the Aozu building.
Yeah, I'm not sure how fun that would be.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. I think pretty dull.
But clearly more interesting than we are. So they got our slot last week.
Yeah, so we're going to air the show that we'd planned to do last week this week, which is on cocktail bars in and around Oxford.
It's quite like an Oxford topic, I feel. Like, I think cocktail bars more than like other in other student areas. I think Oxford's quite a big place for cocktail bars because there are quite a lot of them in quite a small area, actually.
Yeah, we are. We're also bringing some nice old school tunes to you this week.
Different.
Yeah, and the link is slightly more out of the box than it has been on other weeks.
It's kind a big hint, though, is that if you know us, then you should be able to get the link.
It's kind of less of a factual link between them. Mm. And it's a link between the artists rather than the songs.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we'll be asking you which artist you think the songs are and what the link is. Should we start off with a song or...?
I reckon we should start off with the song and then we'll dive into the reviews.
Right, what are we going to go for? I think this is a good way to start off.
Yeah. I think people should be able to guess the artist here.
Okay, so. This is a newer one for you. Have a guess who this is.
yeah, so that was my choice. I was Jess Glynn with Right Here. So well done if you managed to guess that. Should we dive into reviewing the cocktail bars?
Yes, let's do it. So should we start off with Freud? That's reasonably near us here at the Alzu studio. We've both been, which is a good start, because not all of the other ones we've been to.
We've been to most of them, though, I feel.
Yeah, there are a couple of ones that we neither of us have been to, and so the review is limited.
To their website.
Okay, again, we've gone for a little table of ideas for what we're reviewing them on. So we've gone for location, cost, ambience, drink quality, staff/service.
Yeah.
And then a total this week.
I think staff and service is quite important, not because you get rude staff, but basically because you can take a very long time to get served in some cocktail bars, which I think kind of is quite annoying, isn't it? And sort of can spoil the occasion slightly.
Mm-hmm. I definitely agree. So, Freud's then. It's it's in Jericho.
Yeah.
It's in a pretty cool building, isn't it? I've given its location in Jericho 2 out of 5.
I gave it a 3.
Yeah,
I
think
it's pretty
generous.
Good, like, for most colleges in terms of, like, it's not far if you're in, like, John's or Worcester. And if you live in North Oxford, it's one of the closer ones. So
yeah.
I don't think it's, like, that bad.
I think basically. It's further than most of the other cocktail bars from most colleges. And so, hence, 3 is over average. So I would give it worse than average.
2.5 is average and you round up, so I give it a 3.
Okay, 2.5 average and I round down, so I give it a 2. Yeah, I don't think you give anything less than a 3, though, is my point.
Yeah, so I don't. I'm quite a nice marker.
Generous kind of guy.
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah, then we've given cost. I've gone for a 3, you've gone for a 4.
Yeah, I thought it was very reasonable for, like, normal cocktails. But we also do a happy hour, and certain drinks are discounted for students.
Yeah, that's
so they're
£4.50
each, which is pretty cheap.
Yeah.
So I'd give it a 4 out of 5 if you're a student, and then if you're not a student, probably a 3. So sort of somewhere in between there.
No,
is probably
I do think it's good that they run sort of a student price all the time rather than just a happy hour student price.
Although the selection of the drinks that are on that
is quite much more reduced, yeah. Okay, then ambience. We've both gone for 4.5 here.
Not quite a 5.
Quite generous. Yeah, it's a cool building, like old church. It's got those big pillars, sort of Roman style out the front. It's just something different. It's quite very different architecture to most of the rest of Oxford.
It's like a hidden gem as well, because you don't really expect it walking up Jericho, because it's just houses sort of either side of you, and you get to this really crazy old building, and then inside is a cocktail
it's
bar.
It's got a stained glass window at the back, doesn't it, as well? Kind of
really tall ceilings. The only issue is it's quite echoey.
Yeah, it's echoey. It's very dark.
Yeah, they should sort the lighting out, because I think that would make it, like, just even nicer.
You'll probably find it's listed or something, and they can't put in big neon
lights. Lighting, fluorescent lights.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, drink quality. I've gone for a 3. You've gone for a 4.
Yeah, so I had a Bloody Mary there, the only Bloody Mary I've ever had, and I was not a fan, but I think that was more the fact that I didn't like Bloody Marys.
Why did you? Do you like tomato juice?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you like Tabasco?
Not when there was as much in, like, he asked me how
celery?
Hot I wanted, and I was just, oh yeah, I love celery.
Okay,
he asked, like, they were like, oh, how hot do you want it? I was like, 3 out of 5, not anticipating that 3 out of 5 was still very hot.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that was more my sort of lack of experience than a poor drink quality. And everyone else I was with really enjoyed their drinks. So
fair
that's
enough.
Why I gave it a 4.
Yeah, I went in second year, so it's 2 years ago now. I don't remember what drink I had. But I don't remember it being particularly amazing or particularly bad. I haven't been back since, so maybe that points at something.
Says a story.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not sure. Okay, staff/service. You've gone for a 3. I've gone for a 2.
Yeah, like, the staff were very nice, but the service was horrendously slow. I think I was queuing for about 10 minutes to get my drink, and then he started making it, and then he's like, actually, don't have any tomato juice. Went to the stock room, no tomato juice in there, so we just had to go to the co-op across the road to buy some tomato juice, which I thought was just quite bad, because, like, I don't know, I think it's quite like a common...
Yeah, at least they did just go over to the local shop. You'll find loads of restaurants and bars and stuff. They just say, oh no, we're out of that. And
we had started making
there's
it,
a blooming Sainsbury's on the next door or something, and they're still like, oh no, that's not our stockist, so we can't get it from there or whatever. And that always pisses me off slightly. I've given it a 2 because I went in very early evening with my mum, actually, in second year. It was summer, summer of second year. And it must have been about like 6-ish in the evening. I'd say it was like kind of a before dinner thing. And we were vaguely looking at places to hold my 21st. And I said, oh, Freud's is quite cool. Like, I haven't actually been there, but let's go and have a look. So we wandered in at 6. It was really, really dark. But it was all open. The doors were wide open. There was a sign outside and stuff. We went in about 6. It was like pitch black inside, nobody around. We were kind of like walking in, like trying to make as much noise as possible to like let somebody hear. We ended up like standing in the middle of the room kind of going, hello, 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 anybody here? And then some like little guy kind of shuffled out and was like, hi, can I help you? And we were like, oh yeah, could we have some cocktails? And then some information about the venue and stuff like that. And just, I think they put the like newbie on the early shift. He had no idea what he was doing, really. So that wasn't great. But I think that might have been to do with what time we arrived. Although you should get a good quality of service whatever time you're there in opening hours.
Like, yeah,
it wasn't
exactly.
It wasn't as if we came out of hours.
I'm intrigued for your summary because I've just read what you've written and it doesn't make much sense to me. Please explain.
It's not a summary. It's just kind of extra information. So my total, I've given it a 3. You've given it a 4.
Yeah.
I've said, like, as a note to myself, they often do a night called Holy Funk there, which is funk music.
Oh, okay, now it makes
sense. Which is quite good. And that's the only time I know it to have been particularly busy. And I think a cocktail bar needs people to make it sort of a good
it's such a big space.
Exactly. So they need to fill it out a bit. There needs to be some good music, especially in that venue because it's so huge. Mm. So, yeah, they often get this, like, funk band in, Andy Meredith's funk band. Who I've heard, I haven't heard play at Freud's, but I've heard them play
elsewhere,
and they're pretty good. So I can imagine it's good with them.
Yeah, I gave it a 4 because I think like the venue is incredible, and it's quite a nice place to sort of go off the beaten track a bit in Oxford and show your friends something a bit different, like if they're visiting. And yeah, like it's reasonably priced and the cocktails are pretty good, so that's why I gave it a 4, above average.
Yeah. Okay, should we go on to our next cocktail bar, which is
one Rowell's. That we've neither been to.
Neither of us have been to this, so our review is lacking somewhat. It is also in Jericho, so just off Little Clarendon Street.
I'm intrigued just why you gave this one a 3 for location,
I
not 2.
I gave this one a 3 because it's slightly closer into St Giles, so it's nearer those colleges. And there's more people at those colleges than, say, Worcester, which is maybe nearer
Freud's,
although I'm not sure it is. It's just kind of a straight line. It's not nearer.
Okay.
So yeah, I gave that a 3 because it is slightly nearer the main student population. It's like Rowell's is near Somerville, stuff like that.
Okay.
So it is closer to more colleges. And then price wise, we've had a look on the website.
Yeah. So from my extensive research, I think most drinks are about £6 or £7, which is like pretty standard cocktail prices, but they don't do a happy hour, and they say it's because they believe that you get what you pay for.
Yeah, they're very strong on saying they use like fresh fruit and things for their.
Yeah, so I think they grind all of their own fruits, make their own juices like every day, every day, which I think is pretty cool.
Yeah, it does sound like they take their ingredients very seriously.
I think it's sort of good. A cocktail bar if you're like a connoisseur of cocktails and you want something that's like top of the range kind of thing. That's what they're trying to like portray themselves as.
I gathered that.
We haven't been, we can't really.
No, but they also run like cocktail making classes and alcohol tasting sessions where they'll do like a whiskey evening that you book on and you try a range of whiskies and learn a lot about them. And then cocktail making shaking class. I think they have well trained
staff,
barmen.
Cocktail
makers. So
they also do like forgotten cocktails. Is like a page on their menu, so it's like sort of cocktails from the past that.
Yeah, I think it is quite a sort of. They're trying to be a sort of leader in their field, a bit of a educational establishment, if you want to call it that. And it might be worth sort of getting your college MCR JCR involved with them to do a cocktail tasting or a cocktail making
fifth week blues thing.
Yeah, fifth week blues sort of thing, which might be a good idea. Okay, then also the ambience we've decided from what we've seen online. and I saw one photo of it from the outside and I didn't think it looked that pleasing to go in.
Oh,
that
I didn't
inviting.
Google image it, actually. I should
didn't
have done
you?
That.
Okay, you should Google image it. It's got a big yellow sign. It kind of looks like, I don't know, it looked like a kebab shop to me or something. Didn't look like this upmarket establishment that it seems to be trying to be.
Okay. But yeah, I think I'd be quite interested in going there.
Try it out, because I've
spoken to a couple of people who have been, and they said it was good. They didn't really elaborate apart from that. They said, yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
Didn't review it thoroughly. But yeah, so should we go to another song, do you think, now?
Yeah,
or?
I think it's another song time. This one's my choice. It should be pretty easy to work out who the artist is, but bear in mind the link. Here you go.
What you gonna do with all that junk inside your trunk?
I'ma get you drunk, get you lit drunk off my hump, 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 my lovely little lumps. Check it out, I drive these brothers crazy, I do it on the daily, they treat me really nicely, they buy me all these ices, Dolce and Gabbana. Their money got me wearing fly. Girl, I ain't asking. They say they love my ass. And 7 jeans to religion. I say no, but they keep giving. So I keep on taking. And no, I ain't taking. We can keep on dating. I keep on demonstrating my love. Love.
Black Eyed Peas with My Humps. I think that was a favourite of mine in sort of year 7, so age 12. I think I thought it was quite risque. I still know most of the words, I think.
Although you did try and sort of sing along a little bit.
get them a bit wrong.
So, should we move on to the Duke of Cambridge, which again is in Jericho?
Again, I've given that 3 because it's on Little Clarendon Street, so it's a bit closer to most of the colleges. You've given it 4. Why did you give it 4, mate, then, if you, by your little...
I'm not really sure. I said it's on Little Clarendon Street, so it's actually a better location than Rowell's and...
Rowell's on Little Clarendon Street.
Freud's, but not quite. But basically, because the Duke of Cambridge is like in the midst of all the restaurants there,
yeah.
So if you're going out for dinner... Like, if you go for a cocktail before or after, it's arguably better place than Rowell's and Freud's. So, therefore, I thought I should give it... Probably 3.5 is actually more what it should be.
Yeah. Freud's near, like, other restaurants. There's, like, restaurants all up Jericho.
I know, but, like, there's a higher concentration of them, I would say.
I'm not so sure. okay, so, yeah, 3, I'd be giving it good because it's near the...
Mm-hmm.
Near the colleges. Right, okay, so then, cost-wise...
Yeah,
you've given it 3.5. I've given it 4. I'm a bit more generous here.
Yeah, but you've only given it 4 because you only go in happy hour.
Yeah, but their happy hour is so often that it's good.
When is their happy hour?
5 till 9 Sunday to Thursday, and then 5 till 7:30 Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, most so places that's quite regular.
Most places don't have happy hours on weekends at all.
Yeah, the prices are actually really reasonable as well for during the happy hour.
Yeah, exactly. £3.95 for cocktails in happy hour, which I think is... Yeah. I think that's the best happy hour price in all of Oxford.
Yeah, so I agree. But then outside of happy hour, they're £7 to £8 each, which is arguably above average.
Yeah, okay. 7 is probably average, I'd say.
Yeah.
Maybe 6.57.
So which is why I gave it 3.5, because I thought that happy hour is good, but you can't just assume that people only go there in happy hour.
And then, because I've got a union card, it's always happy hour from Sunday to Thursday. As in, whatever time you go, however late however early you go. Always happy hour. So, not really any point in going there out of happy hour.
Yeah, fair enough. I'm not a member of the union, so don't quite have that luxury.
Okay, then ambience again?
Yeah, I gave it 3. I said it's nice design and lighting, but it was quite busy when I went, and we sort of struggled to find seats, which was a bit annoying because of the layout of the cocktail bar. Sort of like wherever we stood, we were sort of in the way of people coming in or going to the bar, and so constantly sort of like moving so people could shuffle past me. So I wasn't a huge fan of that. You gave it a 4, maybe, which is quite high.
I like it. I think it's like well kept, as in everything. Like I think it could look like they redecorated it a couple of months ago every time I go in, and it's always looked the same from when I went in there first year. So I know it's been done like that the same for 4 years, and it doesn't look at all like tatty around the edges, is my point.
Okay.
Whereas
more about that later.
Well, not really, but I
the Mad Hatter, mate.
Yeah. Okay, fair. More about that later. So I don't know. I just think it's quite sleek, sophisticated, smart, clean cut. It's not trying to have any gimmick factor. It's all about the cocktails.
Yeah.
I think it would hold up well in London, kind of thing. Whereas,
okay,
I'm not sure all the places in Oxford could.
So then for the cocktails, the one that I had, and I tried a couple of others that my friends had, they're all very, very nice. So I gave it 4.5 out of 5.
Yeah, they are good. I also gave it 4.5 out of 5. They use fresh ingredients. When I've had raspberry cocktails, are a fave for me. Mm. So they use fresh raspberries that you can see them mashing up right there and then. I also think they do a reasonable size of cocktails. Like often you get a short glass, like a tumbler, and it has too much ice in that you end up getting about 4 sips of cocktail and that's it. They do slightly like taller glass usually for most of their cocktails, and I think they're just a bit more generous with their helpings than some other places.
I agree. I thought the drinks were really, really good.
Although, if you notice on the Rowell's website, they did say, don't ask us for less ice because the ice makes the cocktail cooler and that the temperature of the cocktail is a very important thing.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out if Rowell sort of knew what they were on about or they were just trying to scam people.
Yeah,
but there's only one way to find out, and that's to go and see if their cocktails are as good as they're saying they are. But then for service, you gave it 5 and I gave it 4.5.
I gave it 5. At busy times, I mean, you do have to wait a bit at the bar. There's usually about 4 staff on duty, is that the right thing to say?
Working.
Certainly. Busy, and like Friday nights. But there's never like a thick, deep bit to get to the bar as there can be in some other bars and pubs and stuff. Yeah. Usually you'd be served within 5 minutes sort of
it
thing.
Was also really good because I think when we went to the like up to the bar, the like the cocktail maker barman was just said, oh, I'll be with you in a minute.
Yeah, they did.
Just
they
like small touches like that.
I think they are quite attentive. It is good. And they are very quick at what they do, considering the amount of ingredients they're mixing. They know exactly what you're talking about when you order which cocktail. They don't have to look it up on the menu themselves and kind of make a sort
fumble
of
around looking for the line.
Exactly. No, that I think they're very well trained and they're very efficient.
Yeah.
So that's good.
I think I might actually change my overall score for this up to a 4. I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5.
I give it a 4.5. I think Duke of Cambridge is one of my favourite in all of Oxford. I just think it does its job well.
Yeah.
And if you go at happy hour prices, it's very good value as well.
Yeah, the criticism I had, like the main criticism, was the seating issues. But I think that's because we went on a Friday evening, which is arguably sort of prime time.
Yeah, but even then we managed to kind of squidge in and get some seats.
Eventually.
So I think that's...
But yeah, I'd definitely go there again and I'd definitely recommend it to people.
Right, should we move on then to the Varsity Club further into town?
This made our clubs list as well a few weeks ago.
It did.
So
it's a double whammy, but when we were reviewing it for a club, we realised it was trying to be a bit more of a cocktail bar.
Yeah, well, it's definitely changed its sort of branding since our first year.
Yeah, it definitely has.
But we've both been here, which is a good start.
Yeah, location-wise, we've both given it a 5.
Yeah.
So that's, I think, the leader of the pack in terms of location.
But it's just slap bang in the middle of the high street. Like, it can't be more central. And it's also quite near a couple of cash points, which is good.
Yeah.
If you need to get cash or anything. For price?
Yeah, price, I gave it...
3 out of 5.
Yeah, I can't remember how much it was, though.
So I did a bit of research and found they have a happy hour Monday to Friday between 5 and 7.
Yeah.
When they have select drinks, £4.50. They didn't say what the select drinks are, so I don't know what the range of cocktails...
I remember when we went there, it wasn't happy hour prices, but I don't know what day of the week it was.
Yeah.
I don't know if happy hour is half price, so then that would make them £9 a cocktail. I just remember it being expensive, because I only had one cocktail, and then I decided to change it up and go for a beer afterwards, because they were so expensive.
Fair. I mean, you've given the next sort of, the ambiance, an interesting rating, mate. 5 out of 3, which I should explain that one to the listeners.
I don't think I did a 3. I don't know when I wrote that.
Yeah.
I think that must mean 3.5.
Oh,
no,
maybe.
It is 5/3,
yeah.
Like you've done.
Yeah.
5/3.5.
Yeah.
Mine's a 5/3. So, as we said in the club show, it has an amazing rooftop bar, which is where we had our cocktails the time that we went.
Yeah.
And so, I would say... In terms of that, that's a 5. On a sunny evening, when the sky's blue, you can see all the rooftops of Oxford.
Yeah, nice bit of like sun reflecting in your eyes. I remember
it
was
so
bright.
It was a fantastic location, like such a good view. Yeah, I can't think of anywhere better.
I'm quite looking forward to going there in the summer already.
Yeah, it'll be good. Yeah, so, but if you're inside, I think probably, a 3 or 4. It has some nice seating areas. And they have tried to do a good job. They've tried to do a sort of little rustic slash. They've put some weird like suitcases and lamps in there and stuff, which I don't know what they're trying to do with that, but it looks quite cool.
Yeah, so I think the outside is definitely like its main selling point, the rooftop terrace.
They got lots of exposed brick and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's quite nice.
It's not as nice as at the Duke of Cambridge or Freud's though, so that's why I gave it 3.5 for the inside.
Okay.
For your drinks quality, you clearly weren't that impressed if you went for a beer, your second drink, like in terms of value for money.
Value for money, because they were so expensive, I remember. I think I had something elderflowery and fresh, and it was good. No, it was good. Again, with this, I would have said, I think there was maybe too much ice. I know it went very quickly. I know I remember thinking, oh my God, I just spent £8 on this or something, and that was about 6 sips, and it's finished. And then I ended up just, when you... make out a really annoying noise with your straw because you've just got ice left, and did that for about half an hour, I think.
Yeah, I had a mojito. It was quite nice, but it was a little bit too much like lime, which it wasn't really the one. Basically, it was like okay, but it wasn't as good as the other cocktail bars we've reviewed so far. But overall... Yeah.
What about service?
Oh, service.
Service and stuff. You don't remember.
No.
I gave it a 3. However, I was not the one to go to the bar. I kind of sat there like Lady Muck, and someone was like, oh, I'll go get you a drink kind of thing. And I remember sitting there for a very long time. But having said that...
We did go as quite a big
group.
We went...
There was probably like 20 of us or something.
And I think it was quite like a random time.
It was 20 of us. It was quite early in the evening, I think. Yeah, there weren't very many staff on duty, so it did take a while for them to make up sort of 20 cocktails or whatever. So fair enough on that front. But yeah, I do remember waiting probably half an hour, maybe even longer. Yeah,
but you also have to go downstairs toward it, which is kind of a bit annoying if you're on the roof.
Yeah, it's not that wide a staircase either, is it? If you've got a lot of drinks and like people are coming up and down. Yeah. Maybe not the best.
But overall, we both agreed, which is the first.
Yeah, maybe they could do table service up there, I'm thinking.
Yeah, they should.
Or actually, at the time, were they not building a bar?
Oh, they were,
It wasn't completely finished last summer when we went. I think they were building a bar up on the rooftop terrace, so that would save the whole stair issue.
Yeah. But when that's if it's done now, I'm assuming it is. Like, it'd be quite a cool place to go back to.
I think so. It's not such a large venue, though, either. There's probably only, 8-10 tables up there?
Yeah.
For, like, 3 or 4.
I think most of our group are sort of standing around.
Yeah.
They were.
But, yeah, no, it's definitely a place to try. Just for the views, if nothing else, the drink and the views.
Yeah, so you both gave it 3.5 out of 5.
Yeah.
So definitely one to go to in the summer. Otherwise, it's pretty average. Yeah. So maybe next term, it's one to check out if you fancy a nice cocktail with a great view.
Definitely. Okay, let's go for another song then.
Yeah.
Should we go for another one of yours?
Yeah, can you play my favourite band in the whole world, please?
Yeah, here we go.
Cool.
Enjoy this.
Sitting there, I don't know what I did, but
That was Busted with Loser Kid.
One of Ben's choice again.
Yeah. I just wanted to play one of their songs and didn't want to go for one of the ones that like everybody would know, such as Thunderbirds I'll Go, Year 3000, and What I Go to School For.
Yeah, I hadn't actually heard that Loser Kid song before, but I did notice it is not very original with its lyrics. I've heard them before in many other Busted songs.
Yeah, they clearly songwriting wasn't their strong suit. Just making great music was, though.
Great is a debatable
word. Should we move on to another cocktail bar quickly?
Yeah, this is a favourite for both of us, I think. Good old Grand Cafe, a bit further down the high street.
Yeah, this is my favourite, I think.
Yeah, I'd say mine too. This on a par with Duke of Cambridge, I think. But for where our college is, Teddy Hall, this is the prime location. Just could roll out of bed and go to a cocktail bar if I wanted.
I'm not sure they sell cocktails early in the morning, but no, yeah.
No. So yeah, we've both given it a 5 out of 5 for location because it's slap bang in the middle of the high street. It's close to lots of colleges, Merton, Univ, Teddy Hall, Queens, all of the like.
Yeah.
Which is good. We have given it
five out of five for price.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, well, most of their cocktails like £4.75 to £5.50, like all the time, and that is very, very cheap.
Yeah, all the time. They don't have like a happy hour or anything. I said happy hour really weirdly then. Happy hour.
Yeah. It's always happy hour there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's always happy hour. Classic.
You're not such a fan of the decor though, the ambiance.
I am a fan of the decor. I think from the outside and it being called the Grand Cafe, like the outside is that light blue with gold gilt and everything. I think it looks impressive. The windows are nice. And then you kind of go in and it's like sort of 80s peach marble.
Oh,
everywhere.
I disagree. I think that is quite grand.
I don't know.
It's like
the tall big
ceilings,
mirrors.
Like big mirrors that make it appear a lot bigger than it actually is.
Yeah, it's
quite
small.
Yeah.
I think maybe they don't need such a big bar as well, and the bar's very high. Like, you can kind of see the barman's head like, over the bar. I do think what's cool is the way the door shuts. Have you noticed that there's a teapot is the weight in it?
Oh, yeah. Swings, like, goes up and down,
which is really cool. Yeah, I just think, as I was saying with the Duke of Cambridge, like the sleekness and stuff, it looks like it could do with all new tables and that kind of thing. Like everything always feels a little bit sticky in there and a bit, I don't know, like not as well kept.
Okay.
It's my only thing. So I still give it a 3. That's over average. Like that's better than average.
Yeah, I give it 4.5. I think the atmosphere is really nice and the mirrors, like it's very good use of mirrors. And it is like decorated in quite a grand style, I thought. Like, in terms of, do they have like a chandelier in there? I think it might be.
Maybe. I'm not sure.
But anyway, we'll agree to disagree and move on to the trivia for the Grand Cafe. So, it claims to be Britain's oldest coffee house.
Yeah. I can't remember the date. It's like 1400?
Maybe.
1400? I don't know.
We're showing our like horrific lack of historical knowledge here.
Should I do a bit of Googling?
Yeah. But they do like afternoon teas and things. I think that's one for you to give because that's like your sort of area of expertise, isn't it?
I don't think so.
Okay, well, have you found out date? Oh, 1650.
Like coffee house by Samuel Pepys' diary.
Oh.
Wait, is that Pepys?
Yeah.
Pepys.
Pepys.
In 1650. Yeah, that's later than I thought the first coffee house might be.
Yeah.
I just think, looking at it right now, it is grander from the outside.
Have a look at the gallery and have a look on the inside. I think it's actually nicer than you sort of remember.
But the grandest bits are the outside, is my point.
Like, see, that's quite grand.
It looks so 1980s. Look at like the way the napkins are done. Look at that marble. It's like mosaic marble. The chandelier isn't like a grand chandelier. It's a why are there tropical plants inside? That makes it tacky. It doesn't make it tacky. It just makes it 80s style.
Okay.
It's just not as. And look, tables and chairs. Look, they need an overhaul. This is my point. It doesn't look.
Tell them. Go in and tell them it. I think that's quite nice.
No, it's not that grand though.
Okay. Right. Anyway. Tell the listeners the second piece of trivia.
I didn't even know this trivia until I read this thing on you, though. Not here, though. Apparently, trivia, Will Young from Pop Idol fame used to work at the Grand Cafe.
Yeah, apparently so, for a couple of years.
Where did you hear that?
It's on his Wikipedia page.
It's on his Wikipedia page. Did you read his Wikipedia page and find this out, or did you, like, search Grand Cafe and, like, his Wikipedia page came up?
No, so, like, I don't know why, but somewhere in like the recesses of my mind, I kind of remembered hearing this fact. So I was like, okay, well, I should probably check it before I tell everyone else. So then I went on his Wikipedia page, and yeah, the Grand Café was... Apparently he left school with 10 GCSEs, but after achieving disappointing A-level results, he had to enrol in Doverbrooks College, Oxford, to resit his exams. During this time, he took up a part-time job as a waiter at the Grand Café.
Fair enough, I can think of worse places to work.
And he then became interested in environmental issues and local campaigning. There you go. And then he passed his A-levels, so maybe working there actually had...
Oh, maybe. I've just remembered another point on the... I don't know, it counts as ambience, but you know, I had a whole toilets issue for the club scene. The toilets in the Grand Café aren't very nice. They smell a bit as well. And there's only one.
Oh, okay.
Not the one.
Fair enough. Right, should we move on to the drinks?
Yeah, the drinks. Okay, I've given a 5 for this. My favourite ever cocktail that I've ever tried has been at the Grand Café, and that's a raspberry cosmopolitan. Just mean I could drink 10 of them, I think.
I've never had a bad drink there, and... I think it's like a mango and a passion fruit one that I've had there, and it is just the nicest drink. It's so good. They do loads of quite like fruity cocktails, actually, don't they?
Yeah, lots of fruity ones. I like. No, they do lots of coffee ones as well, coffee and creamy ones as well. They have them all up on the whiteboards above the bar.
It's just a great place, really.
It is good.
And then for service and stuff?
Yeah, I've given it a 5. I've never had to wait or queue, and often they'll serve you your cocktails at the table because it's not very busy.
Yeah, I gave it a 5 as well. I think the staff are really friendly as well, and sort of they banter a bit with you whilst you're waiting for your drink.
Yeah.
Do a few tricks. I remember one of them was doing.
A few spins of the shakers.
Yeah.
Definitely. So
overall, we both gave it a 4.5 out of 5.
Yeah.
The only reason I didn't give it a 5 is because it's like sporadically closed.
Yeah,
without warning.
I think they have maybe sorted out their opening times a bit now. I don't know if they were going through new management or don't know what was happening, but there was a time that every time we were like on a Friday evening or something,
let's go to the Grand Café,
we'd go there and there'd either be a private function on or it was just closed for some unapparent reason.
Yeah, I went a couple of times after formal and I was like, oh guys, I'll take this really great cocktail bar. And, oh, wait, it's closed.
Yeah, it was just bad that it happened multiple times. Mm. But yeah, overall, 4.5. So then go further down into just onto Cowley Road, just off the roundabout to Cafe Coco.
Yep.
I've given this 4 because it's not too far into Cowley Road and lots of students live in Cowley.
Yeah, I gave it a 3.5. No, I just gave it a 3. As I said, it's perfect if you live in Cowley, but it's quite a long way to go, like from some colleges. And like for us, it's pretty far.
Yeah.
In like Norham Gardens area, so.
I kind of agree, but I think 4's all right. I think it's better than some of the Jericho ones, is my point. It's closer to more people.
I disagree, but we can
debate
this in the
greater detail.
More students
live in Cowley than Jericho, is my point.
Okay.
I would say. Okay, then price-wise, I've given it a 4. You have also given it a 4.
Yeah.
They always have a list of about 6 cocktails, which are always happy hour prices. Not just like the happy hour times.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's about 6 of them, so whatever time you go in.
Oh, that's really good. I knew they did like a happy hour between 5 and 7:30.
Yeah, I think so. The happy hour between 5 and 7:30, I think all of their cocktails are included in that, and it's £4.50.
Yeah.
And then they have a sort of list of 6, which are their specials of the day or whatever, and they are always £4.50 the whole
and
day.
And that list changes on a regular basis. Oh, okay, that's really good. And then outside of happy hour, I think. The other cocktails are about £6.50 to £7,
which means
quite
they're
cheap.
A reasonable price for their full price. It's a bit more expensive, the happy hour price, than some other places.
Yeah.
So kind of swings and roundabouts with that. Okay, then ambiance/decor.
Yeah, I gave this a 3.5. It's nice and small, so it's got like I just think it's like quite nice to decorate. It doesn't try to be anything that it isn't, although it does have some quite rogue stuff in there.
Yeah, I would give it a 3. I don't really get the whole decor in there. There's a clown in a bath looking at a mirror, and there's a half-naked woman. Well, is she a woman or a bird? She's got bird nose, face, and women's...
Siren.
Women's boobs. Don't really get it, really.
Fair enough.
I do like the way that the bar has, like, angles from all... Like, you can get to it from all sides. It's right in the middle of the room. I like the little tables around the edge. And it's really cool that the bath with the clown in is like the ice holder. So like ice just comes out of the chute into the bath, which I think
is that
quite cool
or is that weird?
I think it's quite. I think that's cooler than the fact that there's a weird clown in the bath.
Okay.
I kind of maybe would prefer the clown to just be out of the bath and it just to be a bath of ice.
Yeah.
Which is a bit bizarre. Then drinks wise, I've given it a 3.5.
Yeah, I gave it a 4. Because the cocktails I've had there were nice and I remember there being quite a large selection.
Yeah, I think there's less of a selection than some other places.
Okay.
Like Duke of Cambridge, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've had some hits and some misses actually there. I can't remember what I had once and it wasn't very nice. Something with whiskey, I think. I think I kind of had it accidentally and I don't really like whiskey. Probably wasn't their fault.
Yeah, that's a bit like my Bloody Mary experience.
Yeah. Okay, and then, like, staff-wise, I've given it a 4.
Yeah.
No, I've given it a 3. You've given it a 4.
Yeah. I remember having to wait quite a while to get served when we've gone in with, like, a big group of friends, but
I think a 3 is a bit harsh for me there. They're always quite nice, chatty, helpful with the ingredients and stuff. Like, you can pick and choose what you want.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're pretty good.
They also do food there as well, which is
yeah, the
nice.
Food's really good. They do food at the Grand Cafe as well, that's all right.
Less of an endorsement there.
No.
Overall, I think Cafe Coco is like 3.5 out of 5.
Yeah, I've given it similar, maybe 4.
Maybe 4. Should we play a song?
Yes, let's go for a song. My auntie has let me know that she has very different music taste to you, Ben, so I think it's time to go for one of mine. And this is my choice. Have a guess who this is.
It's actually a good song.
of my favourites, Fatboy Slim with Praise You.
That's actually a really good song. I really like Fatboy Slim. Okay,
glad that you have some taste in music.
I just have a varied taste.
Right. Let's carry on with the cocktails then.
So it's Cafe Tarifa, which is a bit further up Cali Road.
Yep. I've given this, again, a three. Did I give the other one a four? Yeah, I've given this a three because it's a bit further up.
I gave it a two because it's a bit further up.
Yeah. For the same reasons. Then cost-wise?
Gave it a four out of five.
Okay, I've given it a three out of five. I think it's quite expensive, the happy hour prices, because the happy hour is all day on Monday and then 5 till 7 Tuesday to Friday, so it's not on a Saturday. And then the happy hour price is £4.75 for all cocktails, so they're all of them are included.
Yeah,
but I think £4.75, it's almost a pound more than Duke of Cambridge, and I don't know if they're as good.
A pound, pounds better.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, and
for the ambiance though, we both gave it quite high markings.
Four, yeah, I think. It's quite nice, like the seating. It's a big venue for starters. That's good.
Yeah,
so
it goes back quite a long way, and then they have a little garden in the back.
And then either side of the bar, and there's lots of little corners where, and nice big open areas where you can sit a lot of friends if you want to go in a big group.
Yeah, so it's really good.
Yeah, and it's kind of got that Moroccan-y theme with low tables and cushion area and stuff like that, which is quite nice.
I really, really like it. I can't remember what my drink was like, so I gave it a three because I just judged that as it won't have been great, but it won't have been bad.
Yeah, I gave it a 3.5. I think it's very similar to Cafe Coco. In fact, they're owned by the same people. And so I always find the drinks very similar. There's always a few that I'd like to try, so it's quite a good menu. Then service?
I gave it a four because the time I went, it was very empty. And so the service was quick.
Yeah, I've been a few times, and both times the service has been quick. I went on one quite busy evening, and it was still good. They had a lot of people working. Even though the bar's really small, they managed to squidge in quite a few guys mixing up and stuff.
It's also, the bar again is in the centre, isn't it, of the room, and you can sort of get at it from all angles. Overall, I gave it a three. I think it's pretty... does the job as a cocktail bar kind of thing.
Yeah, definitely. I gave it 3.5 as well. It's all right. Right, should we go for another one? Oh, our next one is Joseph Perks and Company.
Yeah, neither of us have been there. We do have an interview, though, about this.
Yeah, we've got an interview about it. So, for starters, it's on St. Clement's, but a bit, kind of towards the end of St. Clement's.
It's by the traffic lights.
By the traffic lights, so where it's almost becoming Headington Hill, that area. So we've both given it a one out of five for that location, because there's not really any colleges around there or anything.
And even if you live out, you sort of have to go across Cowley kind of thing.
Exactly. So that's not so great. But yes, we're going to let you hear a interview, if I can find the stupid thing. Here it is. An interview from someone who has been there. Here we go.
So I went to Joseph Perks a couple of weeks ago for a party for someone's birthday. Had a very good time there. It's just down St. Clement's. It's quite a way out, but if you make the effort to go there, it's quite nice. It's a nice atmosphere, this kind of stuff. They're very friendly there. We had a problem where someone couldn't have grapefruit juice, and they basically just remade the cocktail without it for us and didn't charge the extra. So they're very friendly. Nice place. Recommend it.
So yeah, that was one of our regular listeners' review of Joseph Perks. So I think also, I'm not sure if its main thing is it is a cocktail bar, because I think they do hot dogs and things.
Yeah,
as
I
well.
Think. Oh, I've seen also a sign outside that says coffee bar thing.
Okay.
So I think it's a coffee house, a cafe, more of a
coffee house by day.
Yeah.
Cocktail bar
cocktail
by night.
Bar evening. It does look. It's quite new, isn't it? So I've driven past it a couple of times, and the decor looks very sleek. It's all white. Those white tiles, which are.
Yeah,
it's all black and white themed.
Yeah, it does look quite nice. It's just quite far away, and I think that I've heard the drinks were quite nice. So
yeah, I think it's maybe worth a go some point. Another song before our last two.
Yeah, we'll break both of these up with a song, shall we?
Okay. Do you want to
go for yours? Get yours out of the way, because I don't think I'm going to enjoy this.
Here's mine. One of my fave songs of all time. Sure, you will enjoy it then. Have a guess who this is, if you can remember back that far. more Spice Girls with Stop. Love a bit of Spice Girls every now and again. Should we carry on with the last two cocktail bars then, Ben?
Yep. So we've actually been to both of these now.
Yep. So the Big Society is our first one.
Yeah. So this, I wouldn't say it is a cocktail bar. I'd say it's like a bar restaurant that serves cocktails.
Cocktails. I agree with you on that front. They've got much more, a much smaller cocktail menu. There's only about 8 or 10 cocktails to choose from.
So it's up Cali Road. So I think we've both given this like a 2 for location for the same reasons as Cafe Tarifa.
Yep, for sure. I have given it a 5 for their happy hour. Their happy hours are every single day, 5 till 8, which is a pretty long happy hour, and it's on the weekends. And the prices are £3.95 for their cocktails,
which is very cheap.
And in other times it's £6, so that's pretty good going. And they're served in jam jars, which is quite, it's quite a now thing. Like sort of.
Yeah, it was edgy to begin with and cool, and now it's sort of just pretty common, I think.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, so ambiance.
Yeah, I quite like it. I'd probably give it, for a cocktail bar, I'd give it a 2.5. For a general place to go and have like a drink / eat, I'd give it a 3.5 or 4. It doesn't, I don't know. I don't think it feels much like a cocktail. I think cocktail bar, you want to be able to like maybe dress up a bit smart for, whereas I just wouldn't.
I agree with what you're saying. If you're spending a bit more on drinks, then you'd rather it was something a bit more special. I've given it 3. I've said it's got a very relaxed vibe. There's table football and table tennis. And there's a beer garden in the summer. And there's lots of seating, so you always find a space. But yeah, as Ben was saying, it doesn't really feel very special if you're spending money on cocktails. You might want to go to somewhere a bit more upmarket. Okay, then drinks.
Never actually had a cocktail.
Have you not had a cocktail there?
Had a beer.
Okay. I've had a gin, which is really good. It's like gin, cucumber, lemony, fresh, summery thing.
Oh, nice.
Which is really nice and go down very easily. I've given it a 3 because you often get sort of those clean, fresh gin cocktails everywhere. It wasn't like that impressive.
That special.
And it's also got quite a small cocktail list, as I was saying.
Yeah.
But then, okay, what about the staff?
Yeah, I think they're okay. Like they serve food pretty quickly. They're quite friendly. So yeah, I'd give them probably 3. Pretty average. Like not bad, but they don't like go out of their way to make it special.
Yeah, I think because it's more of a like social like pub/ food place as well. Sometimes you can queue a bit for drinks because it's like everybody. Free, like as in people are ordering food there. Yeah. Sometimes the bar staff are sometimes serving food there. Like, I mean, they've got a few more jobs to do than just cocktail mixer kind of thing. Okay, and then finally, the Mad Hatter, where we went this weekend.
This splits opinion, I think, between the two of us. So, location, I think we both agree, it's not great because it's up Iffley Road. So, 2 out of 5.
Yeah, I've given it 2 as well. Although, it's not very far up Iffley Road. It is accessible, but it is, again, in the same way as St Clement's is kind of across Cowley. It's kind of, you're going a bit, but like people walk up and down Cowley Road all the time and it's not actually on Cowley Road. So it's a bit more out of the way, slightly.
Price, I'd give this 1.5 to 2. Although, if we were going like value for money, I'd probably give it slightly higher because I thought the drinks were of good standard.
Yeah, I think I would probably. So, I noticed when we were in there, they do a happy hour on Thursdays and like Mondays and Tuesdays, I think. But it's only 25% off. So, it's not like.
It's quite random.
Yeah, I know. It's not that great a happy hour price. And then most of the drinks kind of range from £6.50 was the cheapest drinks you could get. There were sharers for 10 people, which were £100. Which, if you're sharing between 10 people, 10 or each for a cocktail isn't too bad.
Depends how much you get.
Could be worse, yeah. Depends how much you get.
Because that's one thing I did notice, like, I'm not sure that the drinks sizes were particularly large. I think they served them in very clever ways.
I don't know. I think we were sharing more. We got sharers that were meant to be from 4 to 6 people, they said. So I think you should always go with the smallest
number.
Amount that they're saying. So they were supposed to be for 4 people, and then we shared 3 between what?
8 of us, 9 of us. Okay.
Maybe more. I don't know. I feel like I think I maybe got more just so I was drinking them quicker. But I don't know. I probably got like 3 cups or something out of that.
Okay. Yeah, I got 2. So you clearly just
got your elbows in there quicker, Ben.
It's too polite.
Yeah, but no, they as Ben was saying, I thought they were really good quality. They were tasted good, served quite interestingly. Yeah, so ambience of it.
This is really difficult to judge because I thought certain parts of it were done very well. Like the way they served the drinks in terms of the way they put it in like teapots and put it into teacups with like icing. And then you had like a nice little cafetiere thing.
Yeah, the cafetiere. Yeah, I thought there was lots of original things, and also the sort of Alice in Wonderland theme of how you entered was quite novel. How you had to answer a riddle to get in.
It was kind of novel, but it was kind of like, I don't know. It kind of annoyed me. It's a bit too try hard.
I don't know. I didn't think that. I thought if they were going with a theme, they should go really, really hard or not at all kind of thing. So when I got in, I felt it was a bit half-hearted. I liked the entrance. I liked the fact there was the weird mirror and it said like press me, and then you had to press the buzzers to be let in, and then you had to answer a riddle to get in. So I liked all that. And then when you got in, I thought they could have done a lot more with the theme. They could have had sort of sitting on toadstools and stuff like for the thing. They could have had more of a tea party vibe. They could have had pictures on the walls of things from Alice in Wonderland. I liked the menus, how the menus were in books of Alice in Wonderland.
That was really cool.
That was quite nice. There was a photo booth that was a bit weird. It was like AstroTurf like covered room, which was a photo booth.
I can
see
that.
It was really weird. It wasn't a room, it was like a little...
It kind of felt like this might be a bit harsh on the owners, but that they're sort of like in the process of making it into what their vision is.
Yeah.
And they're doing it bit by bit, maybe.
But I thought it looked really tired around the edges. The toilets were horrible. I don't know. It was very tatty. Like, it was like they had had an idea and it was a good idea, but they'd done it a bit half-heartedly. It also, I don't know, I thought it was kind of... So it was definitely a sort of more locals place to go because of the prices, I think. And people were very dressed up. There were like 3 hen nights the night we went on Saturday. So it was definitely supposed to be a very special place. And I don't know, when I got inside, I didn't think it was as special as it could be.
Yeah, they did also have the world's best DJ, though.
No, possibly the world's worst DJ. He could not mix a single song. It was like sort of...
I don't know, I think Avicii is like
ears.
Quaking in his boots.
Yeah, it was terrible. But I know, in general, the staff were really friendly, really nice and helpful, but they were just, on a Saturday night,
non-stop.
Yeah, it was non-stop. We had to wait for sort of 40 minutes for a drink at one point, I think.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit less than that, maybe.
The other thing as well was that the music, I thought, was a bit too loud for the venue.
Yeah, okay.
So it's kind of like an awkward, is it a club? Because like you sort of had to shout to be heard.
Yeah, is it a club? But then there was no dancing space. It was too small as well, the venue.
Yeah.
But I don't know, it's worth a drink maybe if you go in happy hour time, maybe earlier before dinner, I don't know. Maybe
basically,
not on a Saturday.
I'm glad I went, but I wouldn't rush back.
I agree. I'd probably give it a 3 because the idea has promise.
I'd give it a 2.
And the drinks tasted good.
Yeah, a 2 purely because the drinks tasted good.
Okay.
I found everything else a bit, I don't know. I'm just quite miserable.
Fair enough. Okay, should we wrap up today with one of Ben's songs?
Yep, so see if you can guess the artist.
I think this is going to be extremely difficult for our one listener, but here we go.
Thank you.
So that was Elliot Pritchard with Ocean and Weather. Should we tell the people what the link is, Alannah? Because I think this one's quite rogue.
I think you might need to talk about Elliot Pritchard, who's a little-known artist.
Yeah, he's my friend from home. makes really good music that I quite like. So
yeah, so the link this week was...
Should we go through the artists?
Yeah, let's go through the artists.
Okay, so we had...
Start off with Ben's Choice.
Which was Jess Glynn, right here. Then we had a bit of Black Eyed Peas.
Yeah, My Humps, which was my choice. Then we had Ben.
Arguably the worst song we've played during our time on radio, which was Busted Loser Kid.
Yeah, I think there's no argument in that. Then we had My Choice of Praise You Fatboy Slim, followed by My Choice again of Spice Girls Stop.
And then we had Elliot Pritchard, Ocean and Weather, and the link is
Artists We've Seen in Concert. It's a bit of a rogue one this week. It wasn't like a factual link.
Yeah, but Busted were, yeah, interesting to say the least in concert. I think I was about 10. McFly with a warmer pact as well. So arguably I've seen two great bands in that show.
Yeah, we saw Jess Glynn last term in Oxford. She had an amazing voice, but
most of her songs were actually a bit dreary.
Yeah, they were quite slow. It wasn't her big sort of club hits that she's been releasing.
Yeah.
And then I saw Spice Girls when they had their reunion tour, probably 2008. Maybe. Yep. And then Black Eyed Peas, I saw at Wireless in 2011. And Fatboy Slim, I saw at Bestival 2011.
Oh, fair, yeah. So Jess Glynn, I saw with you, Busted when I was younger, and Elliot quite a few times because he's my friend and just he lives for music, basically.
Brilliant. Okay, so that wraps us up for this week. Next week...
We're not sure what we're going to do. We might just play music.
Yeah.
Or
so there is a possibility that next week, being 8th week, might be our last ever show, because we're not sure if we're going to run this next term. So we need to have a little group meeting, me and Ben, and decide what we're going to do or if we're going to carry on. So yeah, thank you for listening. Sorry that we've run over again by 15 minutes, as we always do.